President Trump returning to Trump Tower tonight as he faces what could be his worst political crisis to date, allegations that he withheld military aid to Ukraine in exchange for dirt on Joe Biden. Now, Trump says he had the right to do it, but he says he didn't.
I did not make a statement that you have to do this or I'm not going to give you aid. I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't do that.
Well, okay, first of all, that's not necessarily true. And by the way, you don't need to say that directly to make a clear and obvious threat. And of course, Trump not only told the Ukrainian president 8 times to investigate Joe Biden, but he then did hold up the crucial military package to Ukraine until congressional committees began investigating his actions earlier this month. And now Trump's own lawyer isn't even backing up the president's claim that he did not threaten to cut off the aid.
Did the president threaten to cut off aid to the Ukraine?
No, that was a false story.
100%.
Well, I can't tell you if it's 100%.
Okay, so he can't tell you with 100%. Look, there's one way to find out what was said during that phone call. And by the way, any other conversations that the president, Rudy Giuliani, had. It was a call that was said to be, you know, so urgent and concerning. According to Joe Biden, he says, release the transcript. Now, simple enough. It is something that the president says he wants to do, put out the transcript.
I hope you're going to be able to see a call. When you see the call, if you see it, I hope you see it. I hope you get to see the call. It was a very nice call. I hope you get to see it. And I hope you get to see it soon.
Yeah, well, that's a lot of hope, right? But it doesn't sound like he really means it because he hasn't done it. And in fact, it sounds like he doesn't plan to do it. Here he is, his own words.
Sir, you can release, you can authorize the release of the transcript. Will you do that,
I can
sir?
Do it very easily, but I'd rather not do it from the standpoint of all of the other conversations I have.
All right, that is Trump's playbook here, right? It's his MO. He says he wants to do something like sit down for a face-to-face interview with Bob Mueller or put something out there like his taxes, but he just can't because his hands are tied.
I would love to give the tax returns, but I can't do it until I'm finished with the audit.
Well, obviously, we know that statement wasn't true. I mean, look, Trump never wanted to talk to Mueller. He never wanted to release his taxes. And we could be seeing this play out all over again right now. Pamela Brown is out front live outside the White House. So, Pamela, that is the big question. Will we ever see this transcript?
Well, Aaron, here at the White House, officials are evaluating whether to release the transcript of the president's now infamous July 25th call with the Ukrainian president. But some senior administration officials are firmly against the idea, concerned it could give Congress the ability to demand transcripts of calls with other leaders like Russian President Vladimir Putin. And as you pointed out, the president in the past has claimed he'll be transparent on an issue as a way to say he has nothing to hide, only to later back down. So it remains to be seen, Aaron, how this will play out with releasing that transcript. But there have been some significant developments. Trump has now acknowledged he discussed Biden in that July call with the Ukrainian president. Amid this reporting, he pressed Ukraine to investigate Biden's son. And he even implied today, Aaron, his efforts were tied to giving Ukraine aid. Now, while there's no direct evidence Biden, as vice president, had Ukraine's prosecutor fired to squelch an investigation of a company linked to his son, Trump continues to insist something nefarious is afoot. Trump's also defending himself and dismissing his role in the controversy. One Trump advisor told CNN today, Aaron, quote, "This is a problem for us amid these growing impeachment calls by Democrats who say the president abused his office by pressuring a foreign government to investigate his political rival."